Welcome to Cell Clips. In this video, we will be introducing vesicle transport. Specifically, we will be talking about the formation of new vesicles through a process called budding. While other Cell Clips videos have focused on protein transport from the cytoplasm to various organelles, proteins are also moved from one membrane enclosed space to another. This transport between organelles is accomplished through vesicles. Vesicles are membrane-bound sacs that bud off from a source membrane and fuse with a target membrane to release their cargo in a new location. The process of vesicle budding is regulated by small GTPases. If you aren't familiar with these proteins, you may find it helpful to first watch our Cell Clips video on GTPases before continuing with this video. First, let's walk through the general pattern of vesicle formation. Then we'll look at a few specific examples. It all begins with GEF proteins. If you remember, GEF proteins cause small GTPases to exchange their bound GDP for GTP. This activates the protein so it can perform some function. The first step of vesicle formation occurs when GEF proteins in a source membrane activate small GTPases, causing them to bind to the membrane. Once membrane-bound, the GTPases recruit cargo receptors on the luminal side and scaffold proteins on the cytosolic side. In the lumen, cargo proteins begin to accumulate at the membrane as they bind to cargo receptors. On the other side of the membrane, the scaffold proteins begin binding with coat proteins. You can think of coat proteins somewhat like the hexagons and pentagons of a soccer ball. They have unique structures such that when several coat proteins bind together, they naturally take on the shape of a sphere. So as the coatomer assembles, the membrane is forced to curve and bubble out. Eventually, the budding vesicle separates entirely from the source membrane, creating a membrane-enclosed sac full of cargo proteins. As the vesicle moves towards its target, the GTPases in the vesicle membrane slowly hydrolyze GTP. As the GTPases are deactivated, they are released from the membrane, causing the entire scaffold surrounding the vesicle to disassemble. Although all vesicle budding follows this same basic pattern, the specifics vary quite a bit depending on the type of source and target membranes involved. As an example, let's walk through the specifics of vesicle trafficking from the ER to the Golgi, which is also known as anterograde or forward transport. A protein called SAR1-GEF can be found in the ER membrane. When SAR1-GEF interacts with SAR1-GTPase in the cytosol, the GTPase becomes activated and binds the ER membrane. SAR1-GTP is then bound by adapter proteins, which recruit proteins on both sides of the membrane. First, the adapter proteins recruit cargo receptors. These receptors then bind proteins in the ER containing an ER export signal. On the cytosolic side, the adapter proteins are bound by coat protein 2, or COP2. As the COP2 coatomer assembles, it causes the membrane to curve into a budding vesicle. Once the vesicle separates from the ER membrane, the SAR1-GTPases begin hydrolyzing GTP. If you recall, GTPase activating proteins, or GAPs, often bind to speed up GTP hydrolysis. This system is unique because the coat proteins themselves include a GAP, so SAR1-GTP requires no additional GAP for GTP hydrolysis. Once GTP has been hydrolyzed, SAR1-GDP releases from the membrane and the scaffold disassembles. In anterograde transport, a load of proteins from the ER gets delivered to the Golgi. While most of these proteins are needed in the Golgi, some of them, such as cargo receptors, need to be recycled back to the ER. Because it is going backward, this type of vesicle trafficking is called retrograde transport. For comparison, let's briefly walk through the proteins involved. The small GTPase regulating retrograde transport is called ARF1. GEF proteins in the Golgi membrane activate ARF1, causing it to become membrane-bound. Then, scaffold proteins bind ARF1 and recruit cargo receptors to the Golgi. Proteins in the Golgi that need to be transported back to the ER all contain a recognizable sequence of amino acids, called the KDEL or KDEL sequence. The letters KDEL stand for the four amino acids contained in the sequence: lysine, aspartate, glutamate, and leucine. Proteins with the KDEL sequence are recognized and bound by cargo receptors in the Golgi membrane. Then, coat proteins in the cytosol, called COP1, bind the scaffold, causing the membranes to bubble out. As the membrane becomes more curved, space is created between the lipids and the membrane. This allows gaps to bind and interact with ARF1, accelerating GTP hydrolysis. As GTP is hydrolyzed, the scaffold disassembles. That's a lot of detail about the formation of specific vesicles, so let's do a quick overview to remember the general pattern. Vesicles are used to transport cargo from one membrane enclosed space to another. They form when gaps in a source membrane interact with small GTPases, causing them to bind to the membrane. Then, adapter proteins bind the GTPase and recruit cargo receptors and coat proteins to the forming vesicle. The receptors cause cargo proteins to accumulate at the membrane inside the organelle, while coat proteins cause the membrane to curve out and eventually bud off in a newly formed vesicle. But vesicle budding is only the first step. To learn how vesicles deliver cargo to the correct target membrane, look for our next episode on vesicle docking and fusion. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching CellClips.